Safely. Nobody wants safely. Things don't want to be safe. It's Todd from Todd's Workshop and Todd Cutler here, and we are back with the trebuchet and bowling balls, and this time today, tracers. So we're going to fit them with smoke grenades, and that should make them easy to spot. But the main thing is, thankfully, we still have a trebuchet, because look at this footage here of this bucket jiggling about. It's going crazy. The problem with that is that the geometry of this machine was meant to do one thing, and I'm now trying to make it do something else. So I have to make the arm longer. And that is why we are here today. The reason that it is important is this ball is going 130, 140 meters. But the energy that I'm taking and putting in that counterweight is not getting transferred to the ball, and that is the problem. So the ball doesn't go as far, and the counterweight energy has to get dissipated through the machine. And that is what the danger is, because it might just break itself apart. So we're gonna set to just extending the arm, and I'll talk you through that process. But before we carry on, help the trebuchet, help the channel keep going. Check out my websites, check out the t-shirts. All right, let's get down to it. I now have to fit an extension onto the end of this arm. So the first question is, why am I doing it? Well, the geometry of this machine now for the weight of the counterweight and the weight of the thing I want to throw is now wrong. And you could see that from that bucket, the inability for it to transfer the energy into the ball and the dissipation of that energy through the frame, which is really dangerous. So I have to solve that problem. And that's important because in 3 weeks' time, I'm renting this out to a TV company and the last thing I want is for it to break. So I'm gonna put an extension on of about 1.2, 1.3 meters. That should make it work much better. Now, handily, I've got this big steel bracket arrangement here that I put for an adjustable pin, so I can use this as the foundation. But I have to be careful to not replace one problem with another problem, because actually, the effective weight of that ball, as it's being whipped around on a, well, 4.5 meter, 5 meter arm, the effective weight of that ball is going to increase massively from the 7 kilos it is to maybe 200 or 300 kilos, I don't really know. So this has to resist any buckling and any bending. Otherwise, I'm just gonna break the thing in a different way. Anyway, see you in a bit. I'm back with a nice big chunky arm extension, so I'm just gonna whack it into place, bolt it up. It's back for hopefully the last round of changes now. So I've put a 4 foot, a 1.2 meter extension on the arm, reposition the trigger, and then the other big change is that the 2 foot wide, the 60 centimeter wide gutter that the projectiles would slide down, I needed that before, now I don't. So I've narrowed it down to a V, and that'll hopefully improve accuracy. Ready to go. Here we go. Hey. So this is the look of a disappointed Todd. It didn't go that far. The pin angle was too far forward. It held the ball too long. It's an easy fix. We'll just bend it and go again. But for the first shot, I really wanted it to fly. Not today. Let's try again. So here's the big news of the first shot. It stayed in one piece. The arm worked. It didn't break. Rock solid. Good. Number two, the basket. Absolutely much calmer, much gentler. And that's exactly what we want. So the force is now going into the shot, not into the frame, okay? So that is really good news. And you can see that by just contrasting now with before. Third thing, it didn't go very far, but I've actually replayed it now on my laptop and I can see that it comes up way past the 45 degree point before it releases. And it's actually at 22 degrees off vertical, give or take a little bit. So actually we've got to pull the pin right back. So again, that is brilliant news because it didn't shoot very far, but there's a good reason for that. Number four, the smoke, a little bit, but anyway, hopefully it'll improve things. Here we go again, loose. I like it. Oh, that was so much better. That was really good. But what I'm going to do before I conclude, I'm going to review the release angles on it. I'm just going to see if we can make any more tweaks, get anything any better than it is. But at the moment, really pleased. My machine is once more alive and ready to rock and roll. back for the traditional conclusion. Only did two shots today, but the Trebuchet held onto the second one for too long as well. So it didn't release it really till it was about 50, 55 degrees. So the shot could go further than it did today. Just got to bend the pin back a bit more. All the things about Trebuchets. It didn't go very far, a bit disappointing, about 120, 130 meters. So about what it was doing before. But now the basket is calmer, everything is better, energy transfer is better, so the potential of the machine is better, and it's going to stay in one piece, and that's all I could ever ask for. So I'm going to be back next time, I'm going to retune it again, I'll have a chat with Daniel over in the States, I think probably the sling needs to be a bit shorter, try and work out what's going on, and we're going to come back for more of this stuff. I'm still learning, I learn every time I touch this machine, but hopefully that'll be the end of the fixing now. See you again. Thank you.